Fox News has canceled MyPillow. All I know is the commercials have been canceled. All of our anything with MyPillow or Mike Lindell canceled on Fox News. And please help us to support us and during this time of cancellation. And thanks for your support of Lindell TV. I believe this is all about stopping me from talking about the election platforms and the elections. And this to getting rid of my voice.
Oh, today a despondent Mike Lindell told his fans that Fox News has canceled him, but more specifically, they canceled their partnership with MyPillow. According to an anonymous source, that's because Mike Lindell is many months late on his payments to Fox. Specifically, the anonymous source stated that Lindell hasn't paid for any MyPillow ads aired on the network since August 2023. The circumstances were communicated to Lindell's media agency at length, the source added. A Fox spokesperson seemed to confirm that reporting, saying, as soon as their account is paid, we would be happy to accept their advertising. But when you are a right-wing grifter and you're in right-wing media, like Mike Pillow is, any slight against you, any perceived slight against you is an opportunity to fundraise off of your audience. So why not frame yourself as the victim somehow in a scenario where you're not paying for services and thus services are not being rendered? That, folks, is a cancellation. That, folks, is the woke mind virus at work. And you need to go to LindellTV.com or whatever the hell his website is to support him and also buy some MyPillows, which, fun fact about MyPillow, he came up for the idea, and I know way too much about Mike Pillow. He came up for the idea while he was on crack and sleeping on a pile of garbage. And he theorized a pillow that would be much more comfortable than the pile of garbage that he had fallen asleep on that day. Which I think is just any pillow, but that's how it came up, the idea for MyPillow. Back to the cancellation, the unfair cancellation he's experiencing from Fox News. WAPO contacted him about the story, and here's how that back and forth went. Lindell hotly denied the anonymous source's assertion, saying that of course his company has paid for its ads. I just checked and we paid them $4 million for ads in December alone, he said. Your sources are false. Try again. A person with knowledge of the situation said that Lindell's December payment was for ads that aired in June and July. Now, this is becoming somewhat of a reoccurring theme with Mike Lindell. In October of last year, the Pillow Man's lawyers stated that they would no longer be able to represent him because Lindell was millions of dollars behind in legal fees. Lindell praised his lawyers as brave and courageous and said he would gladly keep paying them if he wasn't broke. We've lost everything. Every time, he said. No, that's awesome. I would pay you if you had any
but I'm
money.
Broke. It's hard. Wow. It's hard to pay people when you're broke. I know this.
I'm going to go to a fancy restaurant, my favorite restaurant, and have a delicious meal and say, I would love to pay you and give you a huge tip if I was not broke. But yeah, that goes over.
I would love to pay you, but I'm broke. That's a t-shirt. Put that on a t-shirt, y'all. That is one of the greatest statements I've ever heard. Sorry for the interruption. That's too funny.
No, that's fine. That was the end of it anyway. I mean, the whole situation is funny, and that's why I've become somewhat obsessed with Mike Pillow. I always, you know, monitor whenever he does his like summits, and he has multiple summits a year about any given issue. But he did one, and it was like the highlight of my year last year, where he was selling drones that you could fly into polling places on election days to literally illegally scrape data from the voting machines.
Oh my God, dude.
To advertise it, they had on the Jumbotron a video from a drone flying in, flying like near miss over the scalps of the chuds in the audience. Everything this, and where did he get the money to do that? He was flat broke at the time. He is an enigma to me and a point of fascination.
Well, I learned from Rudy Giuliani from having to do a piece on Rudy Giuliani a while back. And I looked at a Rudy Giuliani like a live read for his podcast, and it was for Mike Lindell. I learned that Mike Lindell sells not only pillows, he sells slippers. I didn't know that. But anyway, the point
my
being-
slipper.
My slippers. If you're gonna advertise on Fox or any other channel, I think the way it works is you have to pay for those ads within 90 days. Maybe most places will say, hey, you know, pay us up front and then we'll give you whatever. But at least pay them with by the end of the quarter. If Mike Lindell's not paying except every 6 months, yeah, he's got some financial difficulties because when Fox drops your ads of all places, then you're in real trouble.
Yeah, and the grift, it's a tough grift to pull off because it's a cable news station. The entire revenue generation comes from paid ads. That's how they pay their bills. That's how they make a profit. They sell ads against their content. So the idea that you would tamper with their only mode of profit, which is ad sales, because you know you're a conservative, quote unquote, it's ridiculous. Like, yeah, from your followers, you can get some petty change. They could find some, you know, a couple of nickels between the seat cushions and give you some money. But a broadcast news station, this is it. There's no other revenue stream. So yeah, bro, like you're not getting back on air before you pay your bills.
Right. And they gave him a lot of grace too, because that was what, 5 months where he was, Mr. Pillow was sending them no checks. And they just kept airing his ads until now. Well, you got free advertising.
And they stopped booking Mike Lindell as a guest, I think it was like 3 years ago. So obviously, Fox is not so stupid. I mean, they're conservative and they're relatively stupid, but they're not total bozos. So they just said, okay, we're not going to put Mike Lindell on our air when he's spewing all this nonsense. To me, this just seems like a straight up business decision. Hey, if you want to advertise on Fox, whether it's pillows or slippers or, you know, the rumba dancer, whatever it is, you got to pay up front or at least pay on a timely basis. And if Mike Lindell's not paying on a timely basis, doesn't matter what he's selling, you can't advertise it.
Well, he can always advertise his products on Bannon's War Room podcast, which I'm sure is, you know, it's pretty much the same. It's probably got the same wide audience as Fox News, right, Mike Pillow?
If he's got $4 million in ad revs, hey, man, we got a pod called Woke Bros. He can advertise with us. We'll take some of that,
right?
Some of the millions to advertise my pillow. No problem.
He might pay
our fans like to sleep.
He might just send you a payment notice that says, sorry, I'm broke. So.
Yeah, plus you got to know if the pillow is good enough for Steve Bannon, given that guy's size of his head, it's got to be a comfortable pillow, right?
Right. No, this guy's awesome. I love everything he does. He's such an insane, absurd person. But you mentioned David Shuster. You mentioned Rudy Giuliani's podcast. And I couldn't let it go without mentioning that every time I try to take a clip for a Rebel HQ video I'm working on, it's almost unusable because Rudy Giuliani does not silence his cell phone while he records his podcast. And you can always hear it ringing or an alarm going off in the background. And it's got to be like in his pocket or on his desk. And he just doesn't turn that shit off. He just lets it play full volume throughout the podcast. And it drives me insane because there's so many good sound bites, so many good clips I could be grabbing from him, ruined by this old man incapable of working his phone.
Wow. Well, if that's what's ruining Rudy Giuliani for you, Rayyvana, not a lot of other stuff, more power to you.
Right. It's specifically the phone. I love the hair dye running down his face. Sexism, racism, creepy behavior about Rudy Giuliani, but it's the phone that really turns him off for me.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.